I'm not sure what's going on anymore, but I curled my hair for this, so let's go. Hi, Riverbabes. I'm your host, Leanne Aguilera, and this is your Sweetwater Secrets After Show for episode 311, chapter 46, The Red Dahlia, which was apparently Riverdale's noir episode, hence my dress-up look for the week. But the only things that actually felt noir-y were the random times that Veronica looked like she was straight out of the 40s, and when Jughead said a lot of ominous things in voiceover.
No one's innocent in crime town.
Now today, I'll be bringing you little insider nuggets from KJ Apa and Lily Reinhart, but first, we're gonna do things a little differently this time. Now this episode had a lot of little things that happened that are hard to explain, but somehow provided us the answers to five of the biggest questions we've been asking. So let's do a special Q&A in the blue and gold breakdown. First up, why did Hiram have Riverdale quarantined? Well, according to Hermione, it was because she found out that Hiram and Claudius were making fizzle rocks at the prison and the maple syrup factory, so she ordered them to stop.
I even helped him create a distraction so that he could do it quickly and cleanly.
The quarantine, it was a smokescreen.
Okay. I guess that makes sense. Next up, how did Clifford Blossom die? And the answer is Penelope Blossom poisoned him. And she explained it all to Betty in the Maple Club.
You mean a brothel?
Sure. But that's not all. Cheryl's sex-crazed mama also admitted to Betty that she killed Daryl Doily and Clifford Blossom and that she made them all look like suicides.
Clifford killed my son. Daryl was a Judas and Claudius. Well, I'm surprised you're not thanking me for that.
Why would I thank you?
Which then leads us to our third question. What's been causing all the season 3 seizures in Riverdale? Well, apparently Claudius was creating fizzle rocks in the maple syrup factory and then dumping the chemical runoff into Sweetwater River, which is a really rude thing to do to nature in general and the namesake of our show. But then Betty clapped back with an excellent follow-up.
Why did it only affect girls?
I am an herbalist, Betty, not a medical doctor. Tests on Sweetwater Reservoir were ordered and faked.
Seriously? That's what you're going with? And then apparently Hiram's mistress was the lying water inspector?
I do a job, I get paid for it.
This doesn't make any sense. And it also just seems like a really weird way to connect the dots.
You see, I'm confused.
And now for the biggest question of the night, who shot Hiram Lodge?
I shot Hiram. Hermione came to me. She wanted it done, and I wanted revenge.
But then we also discovered that Hermione was going to double cross FP with the help of undead Sheriff Minetta and expose him for attempted murder. Luckily, Jughead decided to use Tallboy's dead body as the ultimate scapegoat and blamed Hiram shooting on him. So Hermione couldn't help but go along with FP's perfectly placed lies.
Thank goodness it's over. And so neatly, too.
Oh, and then Hermione killed Sheriff Minetta. Again. So, last question. Where do we go from here? Well, Archie and Hiram have come to a truce, so we're gonna see how long that lasts. And then Veronica burned all of her parents' fizzle rock supplies, but according to Hermione, she just made a massive mistake.
And now my buyer is coming, Veronica, and they are gonna want blood.
Another villain? Good, because I'm so ready for a change. So let's close this chapter and turn the page to 311 for all the romance rundown in 7 seconds in heaven. There's almost nothing for me to report here, you guys.
It's been a rough day.
Veronica apologized to Archie, which was sweet. Shoni only had one non-romantic scene together, same with Phallus. And the hottest thing that Veronica and Reggie did this episode was burn her dad's fizzle rock supply. There was one sweet bughead smooch during their investigations.
No rest for the wicked.
Not in a wicked town.
And, oh yeah, there was this bizarre reveal.
And now apparently there's a not so secret sex club in Riverdale.
Wow. I miss the days of them having school dances every other episode. Shouldn't we be having a winter formal or something come up? I would kill to see Shoni dancing together in some gorgeous gowns, and maybe FP and Alice are the chaperones, and then they start dancing, and let's dive into some hisses and kisses, shall we? Brace yourselves, Riverbabes, because the hisses far outweigh the kisses this week. So are you ready for this?
I'm a big girl. I can take it.
That's
That's what she said.
Hisses to Archie's behavior in this episode, from picking fights to getting shwasted at Le Bon Nuit and then pulling out yet another gun to kill Hiram. Where do you keep getting these guns, Red? Your father and I are very disappointed in you.
Think about how you need to shape up!
Also, did you all really think that Archie has what it takes to pull the trigger? Now here's what KJ Apa had to tell me when I asked him.
I think he could. I think he definitely could kill someone for the right reasons, if there is a right reason to take someone's life.
At some point, maybe I could have.
Obviously, they have a crazy past. Where do you begin with that whole thing? I think it's only normal for him to feel, I mean, I understand the way that he feels about wanting to maybe not kill him, but I do get it, you know. He shot his dad, he had his dad shot. So yeah, I think I'm definitely on Archie's side.
But I don't hate him anymore.
Next up, hisses to Veronica. I don't really have a specific reason, other than I just really need a break from this whole, my daddy's a horrible person, but I actually love him, but I'm actually gonna ruin everybody's plans because I think I know what I'm doing, but I'm actually just making things worse because I'm a teenager. Thing.
I don't need you to mob-splain what's best for my family.
But kisses to V's fab hair in this episode.
Nice hat.
Hisses to our Red Dahlia, aka Poisonous Penelope, for straight up offing almost everyone in Riverdale.
You didn't kill the fake nuns.
And I'm also bummed that we finally established that Clifford and Claudius Blossom were indeed two different people. It would have been way better if they handled this unnecessary twin twist differently. Hisses to having Kelly Ripa, aka Mark Consuelos' real-life wife, on the show and then never giving us a scene with them together.
I don't care.
Hisses to Jughead for straight up lying to FP's face about MIA Tallboy, and double hisses to FP for not realizing that he was literally sitting on top of Tallboy's dead body. You're supposed to be the sheriff.
Look, I'm Woody. Howdy, howdy, howdy.
And according to Google, because you're damn right I took this scene way too seriously, a dead body will start to smell after 8 to 12 hours. And since Tallboy was just hanging out in there while the Serpents were having that cover up our murder party last week, that bunker should reek.
Oh my, someone must have made a grave mistake.
Save it.
And while we're ranting about unbelievable things, hisses to Hermione's affair with Sheriff Mineta, who was apparently alive until Hermione re-killed him. I'm so damn tired of the people aren't really dead plot twist. Why does everyone have to die twice? Honestly, I'm gonna lose it.
You do know how volatile blondes can be.
But maybe I should just follow Veronica's lead from now on.
Forget it, Jughead. It's Riverdale.
Switching over to kisses. The biggest kiss of the night is going to Josie for blessing us with her voice, showering Archie with the tough love he needed, and for being the only one who realizes how confusing everything is lately.
You're losing me.
Next up, I'm sending two kisses to the always sassy Nana Rose and to the long-awaited return of Smithers. Oh my gosh, you guys, can you imagine if Nana Rose and Smithers got together? I don't think my little shipper heart could take it.
Crocodile tears.
And kisses to getting so many answers in this episode. They may not have been answers that made sense, but at least we can cross some lingering items off our list. Oh, and kisses to the hints that we may be getting a long-awaited answer from season 2. What happened to Chic? So, here's what Lily Reinhart had to say when I translated a message about her fake on-screen brother.
Roberto told me that we have not seen the last of Chic.
You better not have. I'm ready to see Chic again. There was this one, I forget what episode it was, maybe 11, where I was maybe expecting to see him again, but not quite. I don't know when. I would love to because I love Hart. And so I would love to shoot with him again. And I hopefully maybe he can redeem himself or just be a villain again. I don't know, but that would be very fun.
Why would this girl go back to that place for me?
And we're gonna end the madness here for now. Thank you all so much for watching today's after show for the Red Dahlia, and I'll see you next time for our Sweetwater Secrets preview show for episode 312, chapter 47, Bizzarodale, which will hopefully make more sense.
Next time you see me, have a better story.
But for now, please give this video a like, hit subscribe, and then head on down to the comments to tell me your hisses and kisses for episode 311. What did you think about this noir-themed episode? Which answers were you most satisfied with? Will Archie and Hiram's truce last? What is happening? Share your thoughts with me, and I'll see you next time, Riverbabes.